Hello everyone and welcome back to the more of the Second Reality Project Reloaded. It's the Bones Labyrinth in World 3. There's going to be bones. There's already ammonites in the walls. Okay, it's not really ammonites, but it could be maybe a helix fossil. No, I'm just messing around here. Come on, get. That's why I didn't want to jump down there. That's a little bit too treacherous for my own safety there. By the way, do not spin jump on these or you will regret it. You'll just bash right through them and it'll pretty much... Oh, they bounce! Why did I not know that? Also, don't hit them from the side before they bounce you around. That's... It would have been nice to know that ahead of time. That was pretty cheap. Because they're not note blocks or anything like that, so it's not exactly... Oh, maybe I should jump on that other one to trigger that one to move. Maybe that's how it was supposed to be done. Like, yeah, that's how it was supposed to be done. Okay. Alright. Glad I got to replay that segment to figure that out for myself. That was my plan all along. Oh, Red Koopa landed right on top of the block. That could have been awkward because they don't fall off of edges. So, oh, I was supposed to land right on that block off screen. Wow, really? But yeah, they don't fall off of edges. So he would have just like been moving left and right rapidly back and forth there. While if I landed on a lower spot, I would have been kind of maybe trapped by it if I wouldn't be able to loop around it with relatively good timing. Yeah, anyway, let's make progress. Let's avoid bats. I don't have a single power-up, but that should be fine because it seems like most of the danger is the pit anyway. Yeah, there we go. Now that I know that the block is there. I mean, yeah, the coins were fairly leading me into it, but I didn't think that the drop was going to be that precise. Jeez. I think there's something up there. If I'm not mistaken. I could be mistaken. But anyway, this is the bones part of the labyrinth. And what you want to do is run. Run, 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 run. See what I mean? This is why you have to run. This one's pretty easy though, but the other one that's coming up, not so easy. At least I think there's a second one. I think it's based off of, I forgot the name of the level, but there's a couple of, I think it was like a World 6 level, or not World, was it World? No, maybe World 8 level that had a level something like that where you had to run across stuff and one of the secret exits was hidden where there was... No, wait, that was the one that makes you go with squishy platforms. I don't know what this one's based off of. Oh, geez, that was close. My timing was a little bit off there. That's why I was too close. But close is not good enough to make me take a hit. Go away. What's down here? By the way, this is it's a pretty tricky dragon coin to get if you don't have the Switch Palace. Which reminds me, the Switch Palace is indeed in this level. It's remember that pipe that I said that there was something that I thought hidden above it? Yeah, that's the spot where it is. So I'm gonna need to come back in here with a cape in order to get up there. So yeah, I'm hoping to have a cape, you know, somewhere around in this level so I can just like take it back over there whenever I need it. And should have used the mushroom first and whoops. Yeah, if I would use the mushroom first, that mushroom over at the top there wouldn't have ran away from me, and because it wouldn't have been a mushroom at all, it would have been a fire flower or a cape or something like that. I forgot which power-up came out of that block, actually. Anyway, I'm gonna use it here to get myself set up this time. There we go, and bloop! Now, what was in here? Oh, yeah, it was a fire flower because it just stuck here when I went to get it the last time. Oh yeah, the slope's too high for shells to bounce off of. I mean, to go up of. Yeah. Just gonna ignore that. Okay, this is the actual labyrinth parts of the Bones Labyrinth. I don't really remember the setup of this, so I'm probably going to end up being lost horribly, but oops, I'll eventually make it through it. Hopefully. This isn't the correct way. Is it? No, it is not. It's probably this way. This is kind of awkward to get to. Yeah, when blocks are stacked like that, you kind of want to get the upper block first, if you can, and then kind of mash the Y button as you're moving downwards along the blocks. And, okay, that was the wrong path too, so this has got to be the right path now. No. Football season is banned in this country. Get out of the way. Get. Go. Thank you. I was going to say, is it going to be another one block jump? But no, okay. I was a little bit worried about a potential one block jump, but no need to fear. Underdog is here. Alright, I need a cape from somewhere. What level could I get a cape from? What level has a cape? Monty Monument, I think, had a cape right near the start. Let's see here. I'm going to consider this a part of the same level. Yep, there we go. Because I need a cape for the other level. And just for the sake of safety, I'm going to grab another cape. Get out of my way, guys. I'm on a man on a mission. Alright, I am fully caped. So, we can go back to the level and get the Switch Palace. More Bones Labyrinth. Here we go. So yeah, I'm gonna be extra careful here just to not lose my cape up to that point, for obvious reasons. Really don't want to go. Start select. I really don't want to go back to the other level just to get capes every time I fail. So, yeah, as long as I can do stuff within the game's boundaries, I will most certainly do so. Go away. Wait, would these blocks teach you? Oh, so this is where the game would teach you that the blocks bounce you off to the side if you ran into them, like over here. So, I guess it wasn't cheap up there if I would have just tested the blocks on the side first. Yeah. So I guess that was partially my fault when I got bounced off the blocks there. Alright, so I need to make myself a path here. Just barely made it. Alright, here we go! Oh, the bombs. If you hit them, they will explode after a few seconds. You can also pick them up and throw them into other stuff, so they can be rather handy. But yeah, this isn't quite the Switch Palace yet, but it's leading to it. Oh, it's leading to it. Oh, believe me. Come on, go back in, thank you. I know I could spin jump on them, but I don't know. And down we go. This is more lava than the volcanic lake. It's probably going to be like the joke of the walkthrough. The levels that don't really have lava, I'm going to say, are the volcanic lake. The ones that do have lava, I'm going to say, are more like the... you get what I'm saying here, you know? Go, get out of here. Scoot. There we go. Now we're at the Switch Palace! And it's an auto-scroll. Yep, we are not there just yet. There's still more to do, and you most certainly want to stay ahead of the screen, because there be some pretty mean tricks here. So be careful. Be very, very careful. And quiet, because we're hunting wabbits. I was wondering how far the screen would go. Alright, press that red switch. now, blocks! Will be blocks and not dotted lines. I'd go through that level to, just randomly check stuff where blocks are and whatnot, like where that coin was, but, you know, I don't really feel like it. So let's go, I don't know. Time on this part. I'll do one more. Urchins! Blockade! I bet there's gonna be urchins. And they're probably gonna be blocking our way. I'm just taking a wild guess out in the blue with that. But, oh, I'm pretty sure that urchin is intending to block our way. So I think my guess was right on the money. Although you can kill urchins via blue blocks like that, which I recommend that you do when you can so that they don't get in your way. Yeah. Oh, and I think the secret exit is pretty tricky, and I think, actually, now that I think about it more, maybe this is the one that was based off of Soda Lake. Oh, maybe. I don't know. I know there's a lot of black boxes there. I need to get in there. Need to nudge my way gradually through the blocks. Okay. Now, what we want to do here is find the secret entrance here. Oh, wait, no, that's not where the key is. Maybe the key was on the other black box area. No. Oh, wait, I remember. The key is actually further up ahead, and you got to zigzag between some boxes. I remember now. Oh, yes, I do. So I gotta go up through here. Why did I antagonize you? I'm stupid. I guess I really wanted to get that dragon coin subconsciously. Alright, over here. I gotta go down and up and down and then down. Can I go, like, through more to the left? No, I can't. Okay. Just wanted to check that, see, for kicks. Now that we're holding an object, it's gonna be a little bit trickier to get through stuff because you kind of have this automatic float thing. And, yeah, you just keep moving when you're holding an object, so it's not the most practical way to swim. Although it is faster to swim that way than it is regular. Alright, back in level to do the regular exit now. And it's going to be harder to get past the blockades now that I'm big. No! There we go, good. Oh, I'm just going to let you guys pass by this time rather than rushing you, because I didn't kill that urchin quite as efficiently as I did the first round through this level. So, yeah, gotta play it smart, play it cool, gotta get power-ups to wipe out the fish population. Haha. Ho-ho. That's really a lot of death blocks. And you know what's funny is that it makes you think that Torpedo Teds could come out of any of them, because, you know, they are the blocks Torpedo Teds typically come out of, but no, I've angered it, no! It's that, so it's kind of like a partially psychological level too, in the way that it's set up, because you have to pay attention to where the puffs of smoke, or I should say bubbles, are coming from to be able to tell where the Torpedo Teds are, if they're coming through a block or something like that. So, yeah, it's a patience thing. I couldn't move down fast enough. Maybe I should have went up there. No, I think it would have hit me anyway. Yeah, I'm not sure. Hurry. Rip Van Fish. Oh, shoot! I was focused on the Rip Van Fish and somehow panicked with the piranha plant. Well, it's fine. It's not a long level or anything, but the shame will forever haunt me. Aha, combo attack. Hey, you can get some pretty neat combos on this level with all the stuff that's swimming around. Careful. Go. Yeah, that's a thing that can happen, is you end up getting sort of, kind of, like if you're pushing against the wall, you start to get traction on the block, if it's one square and you're big, do you kind of run into the wall? It looks pretty silly like that, but it's something that can happen. I'm gonna just do that. Just to play it safe. Alright, so we are nearly back to where I failed at before. I think I'm gonna grab a power up here, if you don't mind. I think that sounds like a wise investment of my time. How many of them can they come out of? Because I know there's sprite limitations. And, Rip Van Fish. Okay, keep them up there. I'm gonna try and get you to, move off to that side. Oh, geez. Quarters are getting tight. That's probably the whole idea, though. Don't nibble at me. Please, I beg of you. Dang it. I know the trick to getting past Rip Van Fish is to get them to go above you, but if they're already above you and they're coming down towards you, that kind of makes an issue. That's the idea of the level, of course. Ooh, crisscross. Torpedo Ted's... Oh! I panicked. I could have just kept going up. I would have been just fine. By the way, the arm of the Torpedo Ted deployer things don't hurt you, but the Torpedo Teds do. So that might help you with your timing. All right. There we go. Even though there are some bungles, I think I got... Drop something. I think I got through this level in decent amount of time. And with that, I'm going to end off the part here. I hope you enjoy. And I'll see you in the next part.